नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवाद पश्चात्यते सतारिणे। ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांध्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकम्। वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सगगन रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सगगन ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगत्पदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वरा परम कृष्णा सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिरादिर गोविंदा सर्वकारण कारणम। हरे कृष्ण। बाय द मर्सी ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड श्री कृष्णा वी आर नाइसली स्टडीइंग भगवद गीता। सो वी फिनिश्ड 40 श्लोकास इन द 11th चैप्टर विश्वरूप यूनिवर्सल फॉर्म। We have 15 more slokas to finish this chapter, the Viswarupa. But in this chapter, we have understood very clearly about how Krishna is pervading this entire universe, which Arjuna wanted to see, and Krishna has happily shown his universal form to Arjuna. And we are also very happily understood by reading all these slokas in this 11th chapter, Viswarupa. So now we know that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, He is the time. So now, whenever we are running for time, we need to know that we are actually running for Krishna. Whenever we are running out of time, so that means we are running out of Krishna. So that way, by understanding, realizing that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and He is the time, and we should do everything for Him, so then the time will be very well spent, actually very nicely utilized in this, like very purposefully utilized. That's what very important. So that Krishna is the time, we need to use this time very effectively, this human life very effectively. And how can we make use of this human life very effectively? Only with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So what we are doing right now every day, like we are studying Bhagavad Gita at least 6 days a week. So what we are doing this time? So this time, Krishna is the time, and we are very nicely using it to understand the Krishna's teachings, basically. Krishna is teaching us. So to understand about ourselves, about Krishna himself. So everything Krishna is teaching us in this Bhagavad Gita. So we are, by Krishna's causeless mercy, we are studying this Bhagavad Gita and understanding. So Krishna is teaching us that you develop attachment only on me. So don't have attachment on anything else in this material world. So only you have attachment only on me. So that way you focus your mind upon me, your intelligence also on me. So that way, all the time you remember me, think about me all the time. That's what Krishna is teaching us in Bhagavad Gita. So by thinking about me all the time, you will come to me. So our goal is to go to Krishna. Our goal is not to come back to this material world, to suffer in this material world. Mrityu samsara sagara. Whereas Krishna's world is amirtam. Amirtam. Mirtam. Mirtu. Mirtu means it is death. It is temporary. It's miserable. We are going to die. So that's why Mirtu Samsara. So if you don't think about me, if you don't have any faith on me, so then you will not be able to come to me. That's what Krishna is very clearly, very, very clearly, straightforward. Krishna is telling us that asraddhana purushaka dharmasyasya parantapa, if you don't have any faith on this dharma, then o parantapa aprapya mam nivartante. So Krishna is telling Parantapa, Arjuna, directly to Arjuna, the conqueror of enemies. So Krishna is directly telling to Arjuna that if you don't have any faith on me, then you can't come to me. If you don't have any faith on my instructions, then you cannot come to me. Asraddhana purushaka dharmasyasya parantapa aprapya mam nivartante mritu samsara vatmani. You will come back to this material world where death is certain, mrityu. Whereas Krishna's world is amirtu, amirtam. So that's what Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita in the 14th chapter. Krishna said at the last sloka. So Krishna said Krishna is talking about Brahman. So Brahmano hi pratisthaham amirtasya. Amirtasya avyayasyasya. Amirtasya. Amirtasya means there is no death. When we go to Krishna's world, then there is no death. That's what amirtasya, avyayasya. So also Krishna said that if we understand various kinds of yajna, the offerings, Krishna is teaching us in the 4th chapter, sarve pete yajna vido yajna kshapita kalimasaha yajna sistamrita bhujo yanti brahma sanatanam yajna shishtamrita bhujo yajna shishtamrita amrita. So that's what amrita. Amrita means the place where there is no death. So there is Krishna's abode. So mrityu samsara sagarat. So this material world is mrityu. Mrityu samsara sagara. So even if we go to Indraloka also, even if we go to Devaloka, Indraloka, there is heavenly planets, still we have to come to this mrityu loka. Krishna said that te tam buktva svargalokam vichalam kshine punye mrityalokam visanti. So mrityalokam. Mrityalokam means this material world, this earth is a mrityalokam. So where death is certain. So whereas Krishna's world, if we go there, it is amrityalokam. So Krishna's world is amrityalokam, whereas this material world is mrityalokam. So in this material world, what is the law of birth and death? In this material world, jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu. Dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. So jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu. Mrityu means death. Many times today I'm explaining about that. So jatasya hi means having taken birth. Having taken birth in this material world, jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu. Dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. So similarly, dhruvam, it is certain that after we die, after mrityasya, mrityasya means after we die. That means after we die from this material world, after we die from this earth, after we leave this body. So dhruvam, it is certain, dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. Dhruvam janma, janma means birth. So just like for a person who has born, is sure to die. Similarly, when one dies, is you to born again. That's what jatasya ki dhruvo mrityu, dhruvam janma mrityasya. But in Krishna's world, it is not applicable. This law of birth and death is not applicable because there is a amritya loka. So Krishna's world is eternal world. So it's a permanent place. It's a blissful place. So when we take birth in Krishna's world, so jatasya ki, there dhruva mrityu is not applicable. There is no mrityu, na mrityu. We can say that jatasya ki na mrityu. That's what we can say. So where? In Krishna's world, in Goloka. So jatasya ki na mrityu. Whereas here in this material world, jatasya ki dhruvo mrityu. So in this material world, in this earth, if we take birth, so death is certain. But in Krishna's world, if we take birth, then there is no more death. So we just need to go to Krishna's well, get this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita fully, understand this Bhagavad Gita completely, and follow all the instructions given by Krishna, and just simply remember Krishna at the time of death. Then we can go to Krishna's well. That's it. So jatasya ki dhruvo mrityu dhruvam janma mrityasya. Whereas Krishna's well is brahmanohi pradistagam amrtasya avyayasya cha saswatasya cha dharmasya sukasya ekanti tasya cha. That's what Krishna's well. It is the happiest place where if we go to Krishna's well, we can enjoy there forever. It's a permanent blissful place. So padam gacchanti anamayam. So we'll reach the destination where there are no miseries. Padam gacchanti anamayam. So Krishna's well, there are no miseries. So that's where we need to go. We need to go to Krishna's well. With the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita only, that is possible. So only with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we can make use of this life, this human body. This human body should be used to take ourselves, that is the soul, to Krishna's well. That's what is very important. For example, when we are using the racket, so the racket is not used to go to the space. So the racket is used only to, racket is used only to launch the satellite into the orbit, into the space. So the racket itself is not going and orbiting the earth. So the racket is just used to launch it. Now, of course, with our technology and all such things, we are able to now innovatively find out what reusable rackets. So here there is, every time the racket, our body will be created again. So once we die, we will be entering into another body. So we need to use this body, this human body, as the racket actually, to propel ourselves, to eject ourselves, to escape ourselves from this material world. So there is something called escape velocity. So with that kind of momentum, we should actually escape from this material world. So for that, at the time of death, there is our launching. So there is launching the soul at the time of death. We should actually, with the help of the devotional service, devotional strength, there is yoga balam, bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva, without our mind disturbed, with steady mind, without any disturbance. So prayana kale manasachalena bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva, guruor madhye pranam avesi samyak satam param purusham upaiti divyam. We need to actually escape from this world. We need to go to Krishna's world. But many times in the past, when like the racket fails, actually, it actually again falls back into the ocean. So like that, if we are not able to go to Krishna's well, then we'll again come back to this material well. So again, we will have to take birth here and suffer here and struggle. And that's what is repeatedly happening for us, life after life after life after life after life. That's what is keep on happening. How are we going to bring an end to this misery? So definitely we need to bring an end to this struggle what we are going through in this material world forever. Looks like this is a permanent thing. If we go to Krishna's well, we will be able to lead a permanently blissful life. But for many souls in this world, we are permanently taking temporary life, temporary bodies. This is becoming a permanent for us. Keep on coming back to this material world again and again and again. And keep on taking birth again and again and again with many different bodies, different species. And then die. We have died unlimited number of times already. And we are going to die. In this life also, we are going to die. There is no doubt. Death is certain. We are going to die. But we need to make sure that we should not take birth again in this world. That's what is very important. So we should stop this repeated cycle of birth, old age, disease and death. So this is an opportunity for us. We have got the opportunity now to follow, to study Bhagavad Gita, understand Bhagavad Gita, follow Krishna's instructions, and just serve Krishna, surrender unto Krishna, remember Krishna, chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and think about Krishna all the time and do everything only for Krishna's satisfaction. So that way, we got that kind of opportunity now to do everything for Krishna. So if we just do that, if we just do that by Krishna's mercy, so then we will be able to go to Krishna's way, Goloka. That's what we should be doing. We should be doing only studying Bhagavad Gita. This human life should be utilized only for that purpose. So if we are not doing that, then we are missing this great opportunity. Missing this great means it's beyond words, matchless gift, this Bhagavad Gita. As Prabhupada said, this is a matchless gift. If you miss this opportunity, if you don't make use of this opportunity, if you're not able to progress towards Krishna, so then unfortunately we have to come back again and struggle. And also, it is not guaranteed that we will get another opportunity like this again. If you don't make use of this opportunity, then what is the need for to, then Krishna, how we will get another opportunity? Normally any projects, anything, when you get funding to do in general, if you don't make use of that funding, so the next time you will not get that funding. Even governments, any place, everything, when they allot some funding for a certain project or something, if you don't make use of it, next time you don't get it. So like that, we have got this human body. If you don't make use of this human body very well for the purpose, that is to go to Krishna as well, to free ourselves from this material bondage, then we may not get another chance like this. So this is a great chance we got. Very rare chance, another opportunity we may not get. This is a rare opportunity we got. We have to now make use of it. If you make use of it, then we may get even better opportunity next time. If you're not able to reach Krishna in this life, if you're not able to free ourselves from this material world in this life, then we may get a better opportunity. Definitely, if you make serious efforts, if you make sincere efforts, if you make use of this opportunity, then by Krishna's mercy, we are going to keep getting more and more opportunities. We are going to keep getting ourselves closer and closer to Krishna. And definitely we are going to leave this material world and go to Krishna's world. That is definitely going to happen. There is no doubt about it. So that is the kind of opportunity what we have got. Now we need to make use of it. That's what is very, very important. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we are studying Bhagavad Gita every day. So now in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, we finished 40 slokas. So now Arjuna is actually telling Krishna, so in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, what we are studying now, in the 39th and 40th sloka, what did Arjuna say to Krishna? So in the 39th sloka, Arjuna told Krishna that,
Vayuryamognihi varunaga sasankaha prajapatistvam prapitamagascha namo namastestu sahasrakritva punascha bhuyopi namo namaste. So Vayur Yamogini Varunaga Sasanka, you are the Vayu, you are the air, you are the Yama, the controller, and you are the Agni, you are the fire. So Vayur Yamogini Varunaga, you are the water. Sasanka, you are the moon, and Prapita Prajapati and Prapitamaha, you are the Brahma and you are the great grandfather, all such things. So namo namaste to sagasra kritva punascha bhuyopi namo namaste. So I offer my obeisances unto you thousands of times, and I offer my obeisances unto you again and again. So that's what Arjuna told. So in the next sloka, what we studied in the 40th sloka, Arjuna told, nama purastat ata prishtataste namostu te sarvata eva sarva ananta viryamita vikramastvam sarvam samapnusi tatosi sarvah. So I offer you my obeisances from the front, from the behind, from all directions. Namostu te sarvata eva sarva ananta viryamita vikramastvam sarvam samapnusi tato sarvagam. So you are the master of limitless might. You are all pervading and thus you are everything. So that's what Arjuna is saying. Now in the next sloka, sloka number 41 and 42, Arjuna is saying that in the sloka number 41, Arjuna is saying that.
Saketi matva prasabam yadukham
हे कृष्णा हे यातवा हे सकेति अजानता महिमानं तवेदं मया प्रमादात् प्रणयेन वापि यच्चावगासार्थम् असत्कृतोऽसि विगारसंयासन भोजनेषु ये को तवाप्यच्युत तत्समक्षम् तत्क्षामये त्वाम् अहमि अहम् अप्रमेयम्।
That's what Arjuna is telling to Krishna now. Oh Krishna, thinking you as my friend, saketi matva means thinking you as my friend, prasamam yaduktam. So I have addressed you very rashly, I have addressed you thinking you as my friend. Hey Krishna, hey Yadava, hey Saketi. So like that I have called you, I address you. Hey Krishna, hey Yadava, hey Saketi. Ajanata mahimanam tavedam. By not understanding your glories, by not knowing your glories. Ajanata, ajanata mahimanam tavedam. Maya pramadat pranayena vapi. Due to my ignorance, madness, or out of love, because of love on you. So, maya pramadat pranayena vapi. Due to my ignorance or due to my love, I have actually called you, rashly addressed you, called you, hey Krishna, hey Yadava, hey Saketi. So like that I called you. So not only that, Ichchavagasartham asatkritosi. So when we are actually jokingly many times, I have dishonored you. So asatkritosi. So when we were actually vihara sayasana bhojaneshu, when we are relaxing and when we are lying down, Sayasana, in the same place, in the same sitting, same seat, when we are lying down, and when we were eating together. So, Vigara Sayasana Bhojanesu. So, at that point of time, jokingly, many times, when we were relaxed, so at that time, I have used all kinds of words to just as thinking you as my friend. Thinking you as my friend. Saketi Matva. Saketi Matva means thinking you as my friend. I have racially addressed you many times. Hey Krishna, hey Yadava, hey Saketi. So either due to my love or due to madness, but now that then ekotavapi achyuta tat samaksham. Either when we were alone or when we were with our friends. So when we were with our friends or when we were alone. So many times I have actually rashly called you and addressed you and all such things. I have dishonored you. Basically, asatkritosi. Asatkritosi means I have dishonored you. But you please forgive me for all those offenses. Tat kshamaye means you please forgive me. Because you are immeasurable. Tvam aham, tvam aprameyam. So tvam aham aprameyam. So you please forgive me. So you are, oh immeasurable one, you please forgive me. Oh infallible one, you please excuse me for all those offenses. That's what Arjuna told. So thinking you of as my friend, I have rashly addressed you. Oh Krishna, oh Yadava, oh my friend, not knowing your glories. Please forgive whatever I may have done in madness or in love. I have dishonored you many times, jesting as we relax, lay on the same bed or sat or ate together, sometimes alone and sometimes in front of many friends. Oh infallible one, please excuse me for all those offenses. That's what now Arjuna is telling to Krishna after seeing Krishna's universal form. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished this sloka number 41 and 42 today. Hare Krishna. I'll stop now and we'll discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.